Hi, I'm Jim Hudson. Let's talk about the operation of the TCX59 Pro Tire Changer. So I got a three-way adjustable side shovel here, as with our other tabletops, with a nice fingertip control back here. I can keep my wrist off that handle. Helps with that recoil. And again, like our other tabletops, I can preset my jaws to the wheel diameter that I happen to have. So I know this is an 18-inch wheel. I can preset these jaws for external clamping. That's where I'm going to get my maximum amount of wheel protection. And I know those jaws are going to be right where they need to be because I've set them to the proper location. One of the things that's unique about this changer is this hybrid leverless head. So this leverless head brings together the best of both worlds, really. It's the best of a levered head and a leverless mechanism. So I'll bring it into position, kind of right at the wheel edge. And instead of a lever, I've got this leverless mechanism. So I give it just a little bit of rotation, bring my hook down and in. I can modulate that speed just as fast or as slow as I need to, depending on the situation. Pull the hook up and over, pulls the bead up. Just like that, I got my top bead off. One of the great features of this head is that bottom bead demount is a lot easier. I got a lot of downward stroke and a nice big spring-loaded lip to catch that bottom bead. So I bring that bottom bead up. I know, very obviously that it's on the hook. I can go ahead and start my demount. I'm not fishing to try to get it on the, trying to find that bottom bead. A lot easier than going down in there with a bar. Give a little bit of bead lube here, as with all tires. All right. Now this head, you notice I didn't have to reset my diameter or my depth adjustment. This is a separate adjustment that stays locked. So tires 2, 3, 4, however many I'm doing, I don't have to make that adjustment again. Now the cool part about this head is the levered part is I got a wing back here. It uses the standard polymer winged head of our other TCX series changers. So that wing back there keeps the bead tracking right where it needs to over and under the back of the mount head. So I don't have to think about doing that. I don't have to get a bar or perhaps even use a press device since that wing is back there. Go ahead and get that head out of the way. I'm ready to inflate. I can get my bead to take air. Once my bead starts to take air, I can go ahead and go and unlock. And just like that, I got her mounted. I'll do my finish inflation on the car, but let's move on to a little bit more challenging assemblies here. All right, let's look at a more challenging assembly here. This is a wide tire, fairly low profile tire here, but I've got all the assist devices I need to on the changer. I'll show you how to employ them here. We can still make quick work out of this very wide 30 series tire. I want to, while I'm using my side shovel, of course, as I would on anything, I want to mind my TPMS position, make sure I'm not coming in and about to break that. Again, I'll preset this tabletop for about the wheel size that I have. This is a 20-inch, so that I'm not hunting for clamps. Now, one thing you'll notice is a lot of times these really stiff tires or rim guard tires, they don't want to sit down on the clamps all the way for that external clamping. But I don't need to struggle to push these things down. I can actually use my bead press to do that. Got a cone back here that I can actually press right in the center. Since this bead press locks on center, I can push this tire right down onto the clamps. The cone will center it up and push the wheel down onto the clamps for me. So I don't have to struggle, I don't have to go, grab a friend to help me push that wheel down onto the clamps. So one other thing I might need to do, again, since these tires have a tendency to stay mounted up, is I might need to make a little bit of a gap here for my mount head, bring my mount head in. Again, I got a BPS here though that has all the tools that I need to make that happen. So I'll bring both my rollers around actually, because we're gonna do a few things with them here. So I'll lock them down, make sure they're adjusted, bring them down. So I can not only set my head, but on these really stiff tires, low profile tires, I'm gonna want to lube that top bead. So since these rollers stay locked, they make a nice gap here for me to go ahead and lube that top bead. It's gonna take off a lot of that demounting stress, especially for that first few degrees of rotation for on the top bead. What I'll also do, since they're in position already, I can make a gap for my hook. I'll put my hook down and in with my my rollers, making a nice little gap here. I can get that out of the way. All right, push that top bead off. I can still very quickly and easily demount that bottom bead. I have a nice tactile and audible click when that bottom bead is hooked on this hybrid head mechanism. So very, very nice and easy. Much, much easier than fishing in there with a lever to get that bottom bead off. Give it some bead lube. All right. And go back on. Again, I don't have to change my head position if I've already got it set. You know, this diameter and depth adjustment, I can leave that locked. And drop center, drop center, drop center with these top beads, especially, like I said, on these low profile tires, tough tires. So I'll bring my locking disc down, lock it in place, bring my traveling disc down, and go and start to mount. And you'll notice at the end of travel, this traveling arm actually cams upward at the end of its stroke. So right when that stress is kind of building to its highest point at the last few degrees of that top bead mount, this roller is kind of camming itself upward automatically to help reduce that stress. It's a real nice automatic feature of this BPS. I can go ahead and inflate. If I have to blast inflate, of course, I can leave it clamped. But I'll go ahead and just unclamp here since I don't need to blast inflate this tire. All right. So that was an advanced low profile wide assembly, but let's look at a little different flavor here. Let's look at a 19.5 truck tire. All right, so let's do a 19.5 now. I got my bead broken. I'll bring my head down and in. I want to probably on these 19.5s usually always lube that upper bead after I got them broken, just to kind of help assist with that demount. Get that out of my way. Now, what I haven't used yet on this BPS system is this lower acting disc. So this lower disc actually locks. So I can not only re-break beads, I can lift beads, and I can also demount bottom beads, especially on large, heavy tires like this 19.5. It's actually the quicker, easier method than using the hook. So I bring it in, I lock it into position, basically about the roller at the edge of the wheel. bring that roller up, and I use this roller just kind of like I would the lower roller on any other center clamp machine to push off the bottom bead rather than kind of pull it up over the bead. I actually push the bottom bead off. So get that out of my way. Give a little bit of bead lube here. That method I have found is typically easier on these really, really thick bead bundle, really stiff sidewall tires. Or something that's very, very high in diameter. That's also very helpful for those. So demounting with the lower acting disc is not only a 19.5 trick. You can actually do that on any tire and wheel. Push that down over the bottom of those. Again, I'll go ahead and use both of my press devices since I have them. We'll push on the pushers. Pusher arm, we'll get it to mount up. I can go ahead and get this out of my way. Clear my head. So just like that, I've got three really different assemblies changed here on this machine using a range of different assist devices and techniques. So very capable machine for just about anything your shop's going to see. But for more information on Hunter's full line of tire changers and other equipment, visit hunter.com. Thanks for watching.